Hello everyone, this is GamerCat09, and welcome back to Coffee Talk Episode 2, Hibiscus and Butterfly. We are continuing from where we left off on a new day, so good evening. And also I have my drink of choice tonight, which is not a warm drink, so choose whatever drink you'd like. Welcome, officer, welcome. Hey, Cat. How are you doing? Uh-oh. Not good. Officer? Oh. Sorry. My mind is kinda elsewhere right now. No worries. Work issues? What else? I'm all ears if you want to chat. You're a pal. I'm in a real bind, Cat. What happened? Well, never-ending workplace issues aside, things are getting weirder by the minute, and I'm feeling out of my depth. Are you talking about your recent patrols? What else is he talking about? Yeah. I've been analyzing the CCTV footage the last couple of days. Oh, I see. How did that go? Did the cameras manage to capture anything? Yes and no. The infrareds caught a couple of blurry lines. They ran off, turned a corner, and disappeared. Could have been anything, like rats or cats, but neither fits with what I heard on the scene. The footsteps, you know? The laughter. Eh. Come to think of it, it sounded more like giggles. Giggles? Can werebeasts giggle? Not at that size. No. Even if they could, it doesn't explain the footsteps, really.
I see.
So what's next?
I have some ideas, but they're just wild theories at this point. In short, I'm stumped.
You know, Cat, I've been racking my brain ever since Miss Riona dropped that bomb about the fairies, you see?
Oh, what about them?
As it turns out, fairies was an umbrella term for many types of beings. Anything that didn't fit the known physical rules at the time was to be referred to as such.
Oh, hmm.
Does that mean banshees were part of the fairy folk?
Eh, probably.
Not anymore, though. It's an ongoing process, but the list is getting shorter. But back then, any sentient being that was even remotely incomprehensible was considered that. And that includes apparitions.
Apparitions?
Yes. Apparitions like ghosts.
Jens was right. Ghosts.
Ghosts.
I see.
What do you mean I see?
Eh?
Doesn't this sound like a bad joke to you?
I'm not sure I follow.
Bud, come on. Ghosts don't exist.
Do they?
'Cause if they do, all I can think about is that damn tree now.
Ah, right. The tree.
Does that mean it's haunted?
It could be.
Don't get how you could be so calm about this.
Huh?
Well, why wouldn't I be? I mean, there have been all sorts of customers here. Some of them are so out of this world, even. Sometimes literally.
You're right.
I guess you're not the one who's being weird here.
Don't say that. Everyone has their own...
peccadillos? Peccadillos? What the hell is a peccadillo? I have never, ever heard or seen that.
Peccadillos?
True that. If you don't mind telling me, though. Oh, sorry. If you don't mind telling me, though. May I ask the reason you're so afraid of ghosts?
Gosh, no. That's a long story. Not something I'm ready to talk about, anyway.
That's understandable. All you need to know is my fear was never caused by actual ghosts.
Oh?
Suggestion is a very powerful thing, Cat.
But that's all I'm willing to share, for now.
Okay, thanks for sharing.
You know, it's funny. My grandpop was very into this stuff. So was my daughter. They're like my opposites. Very curious and fascinated by the unknown. Not that I'm not, mind you. It's just with my time as a cop and all, unknown variables usually mean trouble.
I see, that makes sense.
They're the kind of people who can see things from nothing. And I mean that in my best way possible. Like, you know the Zen rock garden thing from Japan? They understand the Zenness of it. I don't, but that doesn't stop me from thinking it's chill, you know?
I think you almost got it.
Yeah? But I'm sure he and my daughter could talk about it for hours. Too bad he passed away before she was born.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Don't be. On that note, Kat, you've seen my lighter, right? I'd say I'm pretty well acquainted with it now, yes. My bad. That thing was originally my grandpop's. He bought it sometime after the war ended. It was to commemorate the upcoming new era, he said, in more ways than one. He got honorably discharged due to a severe leg injury he'd never be able to recover from.
Ah. Apparently, peccadillo means a slight offense. Interesting.
At the time, he was living right across the street from the former town hall. For obvious reasons, he couldn't walk far. So it was a good location for him with all the veterans' support nearby and all.
Right.
Now, about that street, you see, my grandpop liked to chat. Never liked being alone, that guy. Plus, he pretty much hated his bleak room. So sometimes he'd go and hang out with the street vendors in front of his place. They were all kinds of beings there, along with their pets from all walks of life. That's why he had a lot of stories about the craziest things.
Ah, I see.
You see, the street's name just came to my mind last night. Can you take a guess what it was?
You mean...
Bourne Street.
Uh-huh.
It wasn't called that before. That's why the whole thing didn't click for me straight away. But I went through his files and it checks out.
Does that mean the vendors he was talking about?
Bingo. And you know what? He bought the lighter there.
Wow, what a coincidence.
Are you sure it's only a coincidence?
What do you mean?
Come on. Ain't no way they're just coincidences, Kat. Everything is lining up too perfectly, if you ask me.
Uh-oh.
Think about what's happened so far. It was my team that found out about the vandalism before they dumped the whole case on me. Then my car was hit out of everyone's.
Right.
Then my luck started tanking. The broken mug, the fan, the black cat. Just tons of weird stuff happening in the past week alone, you see?
Right.
Then one thing led to another. My team was chosen to lead the investigation. And tell me, who's in charge of the case?
Me.
Then there's the Banshee lady, your patron, with some information I wouldn't have thought of. The dead tree stuff, the fairy market. Information I wouldn't have remembered on my own.
Right.
And now we know why I keep losing my lighter, right? How are they not connected? Tell me.
Well, if you list them all in order like that...
I'm telling you, Kat, that place is calling for me. The case is made for me. But they really picked the wrong guy. I'm just real bad at dealing with spooks. They make me question everything I've ever known, you know?
But I always thought you're pretty good at handling ambiguity, officer.
Not when it comes to supernatural stuff. Because we don't know enough about what's real and what's not. What will they do? Will they hurt us? Do they bring bad luck? Good luck? What's the truth? Who knows?
Maybe you should take a day off and catch up on your sleep.
Huh? What's that?
No, nothing. You know, another patron of mine suggested a documentary to watch.
Yeah?
The focus was on interesting drinks from around the world. You could find everything from the mundane to the extreme, from local comforts to really special stuff. and I kept thinking one particular drink might interest you. Oh? It is something like a protection drink. It's made of coffee, honey, lemon, and a slew of other ingredients. Huh. Protection from what, though? From evil spirits and bad luck, I think. Maybe it'll help ease your mind a bit? Ah, gotcha. But Kat, even if the whole situation is, haunted, there shouldn't be any evil spirits. Right? I wouldn't know. But I might need your lighter. What for? Well, the drink needs to be lit up. Ooh. I just think your lighter might give it that extra magic boost it needs, compared to just using a regular flame, I mean. What are you going to make me anyway? Nah, I trust you. Here. Officer Georgie's lighter. Interesting. So now we have a little bit of backstory on the lighter. Okay, make me this magical drink you've learned, Kat. Okay. So, the magical drink was, what, coffee, honey, lemon? Let me double check. Coffee, honey, lemon. Okay, so, coffee, honey, lemon. There we go. Dude, look how fucking cool that is! That is so cool! Holy shit, that is awesome! Look at it! Oh, wow! The drink does light up, huh? Yep, this is special, just for you. So don't tell anybody. Roger that. Here you go. Oh, careful. Dang, Kat. This is really something else. You sure it's okay to drink? I have no idea. But I take responsibility if anything happens. Ha! I'm just being silly, aren't I? Sorry for bothering you with all this stuff, Kat. You even made me this crazy drink to make me feel better. Don't say that. I'm always happy to help however I can. Thanks. Man, at least with crooks you could actually deal directly with them, you know? Not the case with apparitions. Not with that attitude. Who is this? What's happening? Huh? Who are you? I gotta create a voice for this guy. I gotta try to create a really shitty voice for this guy. Everything can be- it sounds exactly like my voice. I can't masculine voice! Everything can be caught with a little elbow grease. Not actual elbow grease. I won't make that mistake again. McQueen? Is that you? Hello, Williams. It's been a while. It is you. The surprises just keep coming this week. Let me go over there. Yeah, Lightning McQueen? John Wick? You know each other? More or less. We were brunch buddies. Brunch buddies? Brunch buddies. I feel like I'm meant to say brunch buddies in the same serious tone. But I don't like to talk about it. I still get nightmares. I feel ya. I wasn't sure we were gonna make it out alive. We were truly the lucky ones. Without a doubt. I'll just take both of your words for it. Good. Because I don't like to talk about it. So what brings you here, detective? Surely not the coffee. Secret police reasons. I've not read the briefing yet. But enough about me. Tell me about your supernatural problems. Yeah? You need to bust a ghost? I almost said goat. Bust a goat? Oh. Well, busting might be a bit much. I was just talking to Kat about getting over my fear of that stuff. And ghosts. Something like that. I'm weak against ghostly looking stuff. I get freaked out easily. For example, I admit I got a little spooked by what happened on Bourne Street the other day. Ah, I remember that. I know very well that unchecked fear leads to prejudice.
That's why it's a no-no in my book. It even pains me to admit that out loud. Sometimes the toughest case to crack is ourselves. Other times, it's ghosts. How do you do it, detective? Your cases, man. I'd have probably lost all my hair by now if I were you. I try not to think about it all that much. And when I do think about it, I think, who else will do it? Nobody, that's who. Yeah, that makes sense. You know, once you get over the dead part, they're just like you and me. Look, I remember this one case. We were investigating a haunted apartment. This lady, her husband had recently passed away but wasn't moving on, if you get my drift. Real deadbeat, couldn't take a hint. Anyway, we had to go in and exorcise the place, right? But the husband, he's caught wind and he retreated into the basement. I won't get into the technicalities of it, but it's harder to get a ghost out of a basement or an attic. It's all about angles, really. I mean, I get it. That used to be his home. All his stuff is still there. It's hard. I get that. So I'm slowly going down the stairs to try and coax him out. Bam. Next minute, all this romantic music is playing and the whole place is lit up by a spotlight. Basic sensory illusions. Classic ghost tricks. Then, before I know what hit me, I'm sitting at this pottery wheel and he's behind me at- Wait. Wait. Isn't this the plot of the 1990 film Ghost? Yes, it is. Oh, maybe? We had a movie night at work and I dozed off before it started. You didn't see Ghost? Oh my god. That's a classic. The story must have slipped into my subconscious. Riveting. Oh, who's here? Who's here? Oh god, it's another burly dude.
Hey, detective. Hey, people I don't know.
Did you get your important errand sorted?
I sure did.
Dooley, I can see crumbs stuck to your face.
That's just the rain. It's very bready rain.
There's filling all over your top.
That's blood from a gunshot wound. It's healed up, though.
You're literally holding the receipt from the donut shop. That's why they pay you the big bucks, detective.
So what'd I miss?
We're talking about getting rid of Officer Williams' fear of ghosts.
Hey.
Ghosts?
Ghosts? Oh god, it's gonna be so hard switching voices.
Yeah, you're afraid of him, right, Dooley?
No idea, never met one.
We stopped a ghost riot.
Ghosts aren't real. So you don't need to be scared of them. Easy.
There you go, I guess. Sorry, that wasn't much help.
Nah. What you said, that they're just like us. That's a good thing to be reminded of.
Exactly. They used to be alive, just like us. As long as they don't try to eat, slash possess, slash violently murder you, you should be fine.
Very reassuring.
Just talk to them. Feel their culture. Listen to their issues. And spectral wall. Whales. Treat them like any other person. See what's on the inside.
Which should be easy since you can see through them.
I thought you didn't believe in ghosts. It's best not to overthink anything he says.
I certainly don't!
Well, thanks for the advice. I think it'll help. Our pleasure. Now, Dooley, I think we should read that case briefing and find out why we're here.
I already did.
Oh?
Turns out we were meant to arrest the person driving that taxi.
Instead of
taking it all the way to Seattle, yes.
Why?
The driver was a chupacabra.
Ugh. Okay, let's get out of here, Dooley. Good luck, officer.
Thanks, McQueen, a lot.
You too, Officer Dooley.
Bye, guy. Good luck with your rat problem or whatever.
Bye, coffee wizard. Take care. I'm a coffee wizard. Hi, Cooper. Oh, Cooper just pooped.
Holy shit. Oh my god.
Whew. Give me a moment. Give me a moment. Okay. We're good now? Sorry. That was a very rancid smelling. Usually if he poops, it's like, cat poop. But it was just like, holy shit. Yes, successful Febreze. So we're good. We're good. That was quite something. Well, what do you know, cat? Looks like my good luck is back. I'm feeling like $1 million now. I'm very glad you do. Thanks anyway, Kat. I really did nothing much. Are you going to be okay? Okay enough to start thinking about what to do next. I'm done here for the night. You have a good evening, all right? Please keep me updated, officer, and stay safe. Will do. Bye, Georgie. I have the perfect reaction. That was quite something. If you know, you know. I have to say that. All right, then. Maybe I'll go check the stock and... Oh! Miss Riona, welcome!
Hello.
How's the traffic out there?
It's a mess. There's a construction work taking place on Lenora Avenue.
Oof. I can imagine the gridlock already.
Fortunately, I have no deliveries to make today.
That's great. I'm happy you're here. So, anything I can make for you this evening?
I'd like something for my throat. I would appreciate a cup of tea infused with some lemon and a touch of honey.
Okay. So, tea. With lemon and a touch of honey. Midsummer's Night Dream. We don't have any items, so. A cup of warm Midsummer Night's Dream for you, miss. That's what we call it here.
How whimsical. It's wonderful. Sweet, but well balanced with the lemon, and the slight bitterness of the tea completes the taste. Thank you.
You're so very welcome. By the way, you just missed Officer Georgie by a few seconds.
Is that so? How is he?
He's been thinking about what you said quite a bit, actually.
Oh?
He's currently dealing with plenty of clues he isn't used to. That's why he's hard at work at the moment.
I see. Would you mind doing me a favor?
Oh, what do you need?
Could you give my contact information to him? We only connected via Bluetooth last time, so...
Oh. An email address and phone number are written on it. Riona Sheeran. Okay. We got it.
What I said a few days ago may have been a bit overwhelming. It is possible that I spoke more than was necessary. All because I couldn't help but feel a pang of bitterness knowing what happened to the tree.
That's entirely understandable, though.
but it is not my intention to interfere with his work. As such, if he requires any assistance, please, do let me know. It is the least I could do, as I realized there would be plenty of difficulty obtaining information. Oh, I mean, because Officer Georgie is a human. And we semi-physical beings have our own way of sharing information as such.
I understand what you mean.
Okay. I just do not wish to incriminate anything or anyone.
It's fine. I get it.
I'm glad.
Oh. I'd say you've already helped him out in more ways than one.
Sorry, did you say something? I was zoning out a little.
No, nothing. I'll pass this off to him.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Bad traffic aside, how are you?
I'm... To be honest, I've had a lot on my mind of late. And I don't know how to express it without sounding pathetic.
You know I'm all ears.
That may actually be part of the problem, I am afraid.
Pardon?
You know, I've held conversations with more individuals over the past week than I have in the past few years.
Is that a good or a bad thing?
It's troubling.
Oh, I'm sorry about that.
I don't mean it necessarily in a negative way. It's just, I used to believe that I had a settled life objective. But I have been doubting it lately.
How come?
I finally heard back from Miss Rachel yesterday.
Oh, any good news?
No. Our fields are admittedly quite different, so I was not expecting much. However, she provided me with some contacts who may be of assistance. Even though they had no direct connection to the audience I am trying to reach.
I see.
She explained clearly why she thinks I should contact them, however, which I am thankful for.
That's very thoughtful of her. So, what's the battle plan? And why are you doubting yourself?
In essence, the advice is to slowly increase my network to make myself known.
Oh?
Sounds familiar, doesn't it? You can probably guess my concern about it.
I think so. But you could give me a refresher, just so I don't misunderstand.
I feel like that would be a shortcut, so to speak.
Right.
She did, however, remind me of an important and humbling fact.
What would that be?
Well... Oh, but it is not guaranteed you'll get anything out of it, don't you think? Unless you're really, really sure the so-called shortcut is 100% gonna work. Because you'll have to do way, way more than just making a few calls and waiting for callbacks, you know?
I say that's a decent impression of her.
Thank you. After that, she told me a story about her early career experiences, both the good and the bad. Getting noticed is truly only the beginning. Then it is either a matter of letting your talent speak for you, or you go out there to develop connections with the right people. Even then, there's still no guarantee of success. After listening to her explanation, I respect Miss Rachel's determination. I can certainly see how it worked out for her. But then I was left wondering whether Mr. Lucas meant something similar during our first meeting.
Right. I thought it all sounded familiar. Will you try her suggestion, then?
I don't know.
Is it difficult?
No more difficult than sending reels to every audition I've come across. And being rejected by every single one. But for some reason, I feel conflicted about it. Speaking of Mr. Lucas, he and I have also continued our correspondence. Although, perhaps it was more like a necessity.
Did something happen?
He was... stuck?
Pardon?
Actually, he posted about it on social media last night.
Oh, wait. I'm not reading. I don't think I actually read it last night.
So we're getting more information about her. Let's see. Girl always has her secrets. Top of the morning to y'all. Hung over.
Oh, was he drunk?
Interesting. Because they have French horns.
Oh god, okay.
And then we got that and this. Two new drinks. Okay. I might have seen it. Did you? I came across it when I was updating my schedule and responded out of concern. Then he called me almost immediately. He was loud.
All sounds in order?
And extremely drunk?
Really?
He denied it at first, but it was too obvious not to notice. He told me he was walking aimlessly, deep in thought, and entered Cary Park without realizing he had done so.
Must have been some deep thinking he was doing, because I think it rained pretty hard last night.
Well, I wouldn't know. The bus to and from there is currently not operating after 10 p.m., which is why I sent him a message informing him of the fact, as he seemed to be unaware of it.
Right.
So he called me to ask if there was any other mode of public transit nearby.
Wouldn't it have been easier for him to just call a cab?
He told me he wanted to know the city better.
At midnight?
Why not? After all, you operate your business after dark yourself.
Touché. Perhaps he just didn't want to go home yet? And I might be mistaken here, but I thought he doesn't like drinking.
Wasn't it partying? Nevertheless, I think last night was quite different. It appears he had dinner with his team, and he needed the extra courage in order to negotiate with them about his proposed new direction.
Oh, shit. He's going back into the swing of things, basically. Trying to, at least. I see. I suppose it didn't go as expected.
Perhaps. And I know that feeling all too well.
Miss.
However, he said he will keep negotiating until they reach a compromise.
That's good.
Is it, though? Miss Rachel told me about the hoops she had to jump through at the beginning of her career with her teammates as well. Likewise, Mr. Lucas has to work hard to obtain approval from his team for his actions. How can they be so positive?
What do you mean?
I just cannot picture myself convincing others to give me a chance like that. I almost wanted to ask, why do we have to be at the mercy of others in order to succeed or fail? Can't talent speak for itself? But if I truly believe that, with the number of rejections I have received so far, I should have stopped a long time ago, shouldn't I?
Right, that's why it doesn't work that way.
What do you mean?
To let talent speak for yourself, we would have to have the same standards.
I see what you mean. Art would cease to be art if it were standardized, wouldn't it? However, doesn't that imply that everything still depends on the whims of the individual judging you at that moment? How does someone like Miss Rachel or Mr. Lucas manage to be fine with that?
Perhaps because they don't see it as the be-all and end-all?
What do you mean?
Rather than viewing them as judges with the authority to determine their fates, perhaps they simply see them as hills to either overcome or avoid, if that makes sense. Just a matter of perspective as to where the power lies.
But it's not easy to climb those hills, especially if you've never done it before.
Therefore, it's good to try and find out what works for you, or ask for guidance, or assistance even.
Because one can't possibly know every single way to overcome obstacles, or be able to safely recognize warning signs without first learning about them from others. Is that what you're trying to say? I see. Still. Miss Riona? Ah, yes? Sorry, I got a bit lost in my thoughts.
You're fine, I promise. But speaking of Mr. Lucas, what happened to him after call?
I picked him up and drove him home.
Whoa. But I thought you're located in Bellevue.
I am. But I still had unfinished business in the downtown area. Moreover, he suddenly began singing quite loudly nearing the end of our call, which led me to conclude that it would be best for me to go and fetch him.
I see. How was his singing, in your opinion?
It wasn't too bad. If not for the fact that he was screaming most of the lyrics, that is.
Well,
his hoodie was soaked when I arrived, so he had to take it off before getting into my car. Thankfully, the water did not completely soak through his shirt, so he remained relatively dry. However, I still had to lay down the seat covers as his fur got rather wet.
Ah, hope he didn't get sick then. Aside from all that, was he okay? Considering the situation you mentioned earlier, I mean?
Well, he happily asked me to do karaoke with him, which I declined.
Probably for the best. Could have been entertaining, though.
I ended up taking him for a drive, though, as I needed to take care of my unfinished business.
A late night delivery?
No, I was buying a pie.
At midnight?
Yes. Why, concerned you might have a competitor?
No, not at all. Maybe a little bit.
Oh, Kat, you will be fine.
I sort of want to know so I can inform Officer Georgie about it.
Oh, why?
His daughter loves pies. When his car was vandalized, Officer Georgie had plans to buy pies for his family's get-together. But the report took a while and the weather was bad. And by the time he was able to get a taxi, he thought everything was already closed.
I see.
But he takes pride in being a Seattleite. So I wonder if he knows about it already.
Well, it is a very small kiosk attached to a pub. Very easy to miss. The spot is known as Disco Pie. It serves fresh pies until 1 a.m.
Dude, I want a pie place that serves pie until 1. Hello, Dog Nozzle. And Lucas, I've become so numb. I can't feel you there. That's amazing. Yes, welcome back, Dog. I'm glad you made it. My voice performance is being very challenged tonight because there were a few new characters at the beginning. Interesting. Good to know. Thanks. Oops. Getting back to the story, though. You both went for pies, then?
Yes, and that seemed to fascinate him for some reason.
What did you each get?
He ordered a slice of warm apple crumble with a scoop of French vanilla ice cream on top.
Mmm. Oh my god, I want that.
And a large cup of piping hot coffee with a little bit of milk.
Ouch. I feel betrayed, truly.
Oh. But it was my suggestion since I thought he needed to warm up.
Double ouch.
I apologize?
I'll live. A little piece of advice, though. A glass of warm water might have been better for the inebriated. Coffee's not the best at retaining fluids and thus prevents
thus preventing hangovers. Oh.
Oh, that's really good information to know. This is why you are the best barista cat, thank you.
Okay, my feelings are hurt slightly less now. And what did you get for yourself?
I had a slice of hibiscus blueberry mint pie myself. And just so you know, I did not order anything to drink.
Good. Drinks aside, what an interesting combination for a pie. How did you like it?
I enjoyed it. You serve hibiscus here too, don't you? I'll remember to order it next time.
Please do.
And so, we continued our conversation afterwards. That was when he told me he had not given up on his goal, despite the many disappointments with his team, and also told me why he does not drive at all.
Really? Why?
It is... On second thought, it may be better to hear the story directly from him another time. I apologize.
No problem, I understand.
We also discussed quite a few things we have in common.
Really?
Yes, surprisingly. And before we knew it, it was already nearing 5 a.m.
Must have been a gripping conversation.
I am not sure. However, his exhaustion seemed to finally catch up with him. Then I drove him home.
Weren't you tired as well? She's a banshee, dude. Like, she don't sleep, you kidding me?
No. I should go now.
All right, will you be okay?
I have a lot to think about. Thank you for being patient with my concerns, Kat.
No problem at all, anytime.
Have a good evening then, Kat.
Come back again soon. I think she's the thing that they're trying to figure out about the tree. I feel like it's all connected. All of it is connected to her. Every single one. God, it rains every fucking day here. I would hate living here. My basement has been flooded 4 times over. It's just raining all the freaking time. At least it's pretty. Researcher responds over alleged algae invasion. Dwarfira Tech teams up with Golemix Industries to produce self-healing concrete technology. Alien sightings increase. Is this an invasion? Oh boy, here we go. Oh? Bailey's? Heya. Uh-oh. What am I doing? Am I not focusing? Knock, knock. Anyone there? Mr. Bailey's, hi. I'm sorry, I didn't hear you come in.
No, I heard you. My other self didn't hear you. Hello, sir.
Cooper heard you. How are you tonight?
I'm all right. But you look pretty distracted. A penny for your thoughts?
Ah, you can have them for free. I was just pondering the sun side of things. How different the world is under the surface compared to what we think it is. Nothing and no one is exactly what they appear to be.
Uh-oh. Funny, I was having similar thoughts on my way here. I guess now that we spend so much time on social media, people believe we can be summed up in a picture or a sentence. But it's not like that. It's not that easy to know someone. Even if that someone is yourself.
Especially if that someone is yourself.
Sounds like we agree on this.
We sure do. And it's been on my mind a lot in the past few days.
Does that have anything to do with your wedding to Miss Lua?
Got it in one. How are things on that front? A few days ago, we decided to take some time apart to think.
That sounds ominous.
No, I don't mean it like that. It wasn't a breakup or even a break.
Phew! We've been through so much. There's no walking back on our relationship now. But sometimes you're so together that you lose sight of the big picture, you know? I think I see what you mean. So we decided to give each other a bit of space and figure out what we really wanted out of our wedding. And more importantly, out of our marriage. I see. Have you made any progress on that front? I'm gonna say no. Do you want the short version or the long version? Hello, Leaping Devil, welcome. Thank you for popping in, and I hope you have a good night. Thank you. I'm always here to hear the full story. All right, then. I'm going to tell you everything. Let's get comfy. Get comfy. Everybody get comfy. Okay. But I think I should order first. Sure thing. What can I make you tonight? I'm not feeling fussy. Anything warm would do. So anything, really. Makes sense. How about some herbal tea, then? Hibiscus? Butterfly pea? Butterfly pea or hibiscus sounds great. With milk and honey, please. Did I do either one of them before with milk or honey? Let me see. I'm trying to unlock all of my stuff. So we did that with milk and honey. We did that with milk and honey. Milk and honey. Milk, honey. So what happens if you make it with honey milk? I kind of want to try it. Is it anything warm will do? So let's do hibiscus, then honey, then milk. He said anything, so honey, milk, hibiscus. Let's do some art. Let's do some art. Okay. We're going to go. And then. I call it a cactus. And then we're gonna do some little whooshy things. Now it's a tree. Everything's fine. This looks beautiful. I don't know what you guys are complaining about. My artistic skills in coffee are amazing. Look how fucking awesome this is. You guys are jealous of my coffee art. I call this spooky tree. Isn't this amazing? Look at this spooky tree I've made for all of you. You are never going to get something that cool looking in real life. Look how freaking cool that looks. I'm a servant. Let's try it. Here you go. I hope you like it. It's not bad, although not quite what I had in mind. Thanks, Kat. I'm so sorry, it's not exactly right. Is it good enough that you tell me the rest of your story, though? Of course, if you're still up for it. So does that unlock it in my thing? Or is it not a thing? Ah, it's not a thing. Let's see what we got here. Glasses. Normal schedule. Cute. Okay, so nothing else really. In fact, who's here to join us? It's not Neil! Oh my god, it's Amanda! Yes! Oh, these three! Oh, it's gonna be great! Good evening. Hi, Kat. And hi,
I don't think we've met before. I'm Silver. I forgot his name. Not his name, but his, voice. I'm Bailey's. Nice to meet you. And I'm guessing you're Amanda? We are, but you do not appear to be a hive. And how did you? Lua told me she ran into you a week ago, or so. Oh, the nice earthling we met on our first night here. That is a satisfactory explanation. And so, you are her date? I'm a little more than that. I'm her fiancé. Truly? Fiancé is a successful outcome of dates with a 0.013p probability. Congratulations on your excellent odds actualization. Thank you. Now, Cafe Offspring, we are wishing for a drink. Cafe Offspring? How did you acquire that new title? Ahem. Alright, sounds like something I shouldn't prod too hard. Never mind me. You were about to order, Amanda? We were. And what we wish for is a memorable parting experience. Ah, I suspected something like that. Last visit in a while, huh? That is accurate. I take it you've completed your research on Earth? Almost. We are quite satisfied with the outcomes of our missions. Interesting. That sounds like there's a story there. But first, tell me, what sort of experience are you after? We wish to have something we have never had before. It's time to get creative, then. Yes, take care not to reuse any ingredient you have served us in the past. I don't remember what I've served you. What have I served you? What happens? I want to make... Let me see. So we have... What we got? We did ginger. We did milk honey, ginger honey. What happens? I mean, they can't really taste that well. So let's try a hibiscus with do hibiscus, lemon, and mint. I want to do some weird concoction here. Like, see what we've done with this. We've done... So that mint and lemon makes that. So what happens if we do mint and lemon? With this. Mint, lemon, hibiscus. I'm going off script. It's cute. It's cute. It is really pretty. It's like a purple. I like it. Let's try. Here you go. Hopefully this tastes new to you. It does. It is at least 56.941% different from anything else we have experienced. We are, as Earthlings would express, delighted. According to our calculations, this is our 39,846th new experience since arriving on Earth. That's quite a lot. Perhaps, however, most of them were rather insignificant in nature. Oh, what about this one? This one is in the 99th percentile of significance. Is that good or bad? She means it's very significant, right, Amanda? Very much so. We enjoyed this place, and we will miss it. That's... Ahem, don't mind me. Getting a bit emotional here. Anyhow, I trust the agent gave you no more trouble. That one was quite close, actually. We had a little brush with the authorities, you see. Yeah, Lua mentioned that. He made her really angry. She was still seething when she came home that night. Please tell her I'm grateful for that. Well, that agent kept looking into things even after his second visit here. But that's where your help really came in handy, Kat.
My help?
Yes, the card you got off the agent. We asked for help from an associate to run it through the mind you call computer. Once the contents of the card had been unveiled, we analyzed the language of its communication, which is quite an interesting mix, if we may say so. It is roughly 60.0923% syntax and 39.9077% mathematics. We then led a polynomial time attack on its encryption, expressing the ciphertext as, "The point is, Amanda managed to get into the fire system. She obfuscated all mentions of any of us or save beyond recognition. And some totally legitimate orders came in to send the agent to Europe on an urgent mission, which should last more than long enough for him to forget all about us."
Woo, that sounds incredible.
It does sound thrilling. It was a very simple matter of applying Hive knowledge.
Be that as it may, that's great work, Amanda.
We are pleased.
Amanda is amazing. But let's not forget who got the card in the first place. You really helped us there, Kat. Thank you.
I'm very glad to hear that, and very relieved.
Yes, we have thought on it for a while, and we have decided we do not care for that sort of excitement. Not if it makes our siblings so sad.
You really gotten a hang of emotions now, haven't you, Amanda?
Thank you, offspring. If that is the case, we are content. That means our mission is well and truly accomplished.
Did you come here specifically to pick up Earthling emotions?
No, we came here for the purposes of general Earthling research. But it appears to us that emotions are one of the most interesting aspects. We will be submitting a, you call it, academic paper. Uncontrolled stimuli and reflexive neural patterns, deep level communication in hive versus non-hive species.
Wow. That's how you know it's serious research. I don't even understand the title.
Amanda was always the brains in the family.
That wasn't your only mission though, Amanda, right? If you're leaving, does that mean?
Yes.
Ooh!
Pearl and I did go out on a date.
Right! You're looking for love, aren't you?
I am. I was, I think. I think I may have found it.
Wait, wasn't the first date a really short time ago?
Just a couple of days. But I've been waiting a while, and I really think this is it. When I took up this mission from the Hive, when I came to Earth, and during the entire process when I changed and changed, what I was hoping was that someone would see me for who I am, and I really think she does.
That's so great, but I'm curious. Doesn't being in a Hive provide that experience of feeling seen?
It does, and it does not. And in fact, we hope that is something our research might improve. The Hive sees thoughts and desires honestly, but it is not able to communicate the reasons for those desires, the emotions, as it were. We do not dwell on those, nor will we start to do in excess. But it seems to us now that they may be worth conveying, at least to some extent.
Yes, Wow, I'm inventing words. Yes, what Amanda said is a part of it. I was very unaware of my emotions when I first came to Earth, and I was really bad at communicating them clearly to others. In some ways, I still am. It will always be harder for me to grasp them than for most people. But when I started to understand them, I was both fascinated and scared, which is not an uncommon experience, I think.
It's really not. It requires a good deal of courage to look at your emotions honestly.
It certainly requires some time, and even more time to find someone who can look at them with you, not get scared and take them as they are, someone who could see you clearly and kindly. It is a precious thing when that happens, huh? A rare and beautiful thing.
Has that been your experience with Lua?
It definitely has. I almost forgot how much it mattered, too. I'm lucky that I have good friends who reminded me of that.
So does that mean you and Lua found some answers?
Oh, the heck with it. I can't hold my tongue any longer.
I'm sorry to interrupt your goodbyes, you guys, but...
Kat, I'd like to officially invite you to a little surprise ceremony.
Which will take place 3 days hence.
What?
Whoa.
Wait.
What? They're getting married in a couple days now? Oh my god.
Wow, that's some answers indeed.
Yeah.
Taking a little time to think really cleared our heads. We had gotten bogged down in the details and in our own securities, to be honest. So we decided to make it simple again. No fuss, no massive expense, nothing like that. Just us and our closest family members, whether we got them at birth or chose them ourselves.
I am very touched, Mr. Bailey's.
Ah, come on, Kat. You know you mean a lot to the two of us, as does this place. Speaking of which, I also have Hyde's invitation here.
Oh, they invited Hyde! Oh, do we get to be bridesmaids? That was amazing. Oh my god.
Well, Hyde and Gala's invitation, seeing how that's his obvious plus one, would you give it to them when you see them? It would be an honor. Oh.
Silver and Amanda, I don't have a card for you, but you're in the Cafe family as well, so I'm sure Lua won't mind. Would you like to join us for the party?
Party? This is our first experience being invited to a party. It is 99.999% pleasant and 0.001% disappointing that we have to refuse.
Yes, I truly appreciate the offer, Bailey's, but sadly we are leaving Seattle tomorrow.
Really? That's more sudden than I expected. Are you going back to space then, Amanda?
Not yet. We are going on an adventure.
That sounds very exciting.
It really is. Amanda and I are taking a trip through the country, and maybe even a bit further if we've got time. We're basically going to be tourists.
Tourist is such a fascinating concept. Although our sibling explained it to us multiple times, we still find it very hard to comprehend. We always thought that traveling must have a mission, a purpose. But it seems that tourism is traveling with no other purpose than traveling. Which is, in essence, circular reasoning.
It may well be, but it's still a lot of fun. In fact, I'd say that's the real purpose of tourism. To have fun, to relax, to see beautiful things. To enjoy life, you know?
Enjoyment as a purpose. That is new to us, but we are 99.999% excited to try it out.
And so am I. I've never been out of Seattle since I arrived. I guess I was afraid that I wouldn't be able to blend in. That I wouldn't have to restart everything from scratch. But knowing that you're here, Kat, that I always have a place to return to when I'll feel home, well, that makes me a lot less nervous.
I'm very happy to hear that.
Oh.
I think I should order a drink.
Of course, what can I make you?
I'd like it to reflect the spirit of our upcoming adventure. But I'm also in the mood for something sweet and soothing.
So sweet and soothing, but with an adventurous kick.
Yes, that's exactly right.
Then how about hot chocolate with something extra to make it fun?
Ah, I'd love that. Hot chocolate with some sweetness and some spice would be amazing.
Mmm. Okay. Let's see. Let's see, hot chocolate. Let's do cocoa. Ooh, what happens? Sweetness and some spice. So honey and ginger? Or cinnamon?
No. I want cocoa, honey, ginger. There you go. See what that does. Ooh! 299.792.458. Hell yeah! And then, what is the... That's Bailey. Oh, that's Riona. Okay. Serve it. There you go. Here's a 299.792.458 for a light speed traveler. Oh, we like this name. It is evocative and adventurous. Evocative? Yes, it is the speed of light, not evocative of great adventures. The speed of light. Oh, wow. Way to target your audience, Cat. Thank you. But do you like the taste, Silver? I love it. This is exactly what I wanted. It's got the spicy kick of ginger to start with, which keeps you on your toes, and then the honey makes it sweet and comfortable. In fact, it reminds me of you, Amanda. That how does a taste remind you of us? I guess he's saying that you're sweet but with a strong character as well. Aww. That's about right. We do not entirely comprehend it, and yet we are pleased. Well, that's settled then. Whenever you, Miss Amanda Silver, you can come here and I'll make you this drink. I'd like that. Thank you, Cat. Wow, careful there. You don't want to spill a drink you enjoy this much. Ah, you're right. I'm just so excited. I can barely sit still. I can imagine. A first trip across the country is a big deal. It is, but that's not the only reason I'm excited. What happened? Okay, that was quite the dramatic pause. I really want to know what you're going to say now. You guys seem to lead very interesting lives. Oh, not at all. I think I'm quite a boring person. With a secret society and an alien background. It's true that some of my life circumstances are a bit unusual. But this particular thing is very commonplace. Our sibling is excited because his date will be joining us. Ah, they're taking their date across. Oh! And in fact, we must be fair and acknowledge that we may have misjudged her based on her lack of facial symmetry. Although Pearl's features are 9.231% different from left to right. We agree with her movie analysis 99.999%. Wow, hold on. Amanda, you have met Pearl and you talked about movies? And now she's joining you two on a holiday? How did any of that happen? We watched orc westerns all together last night. Pearl likes them a lot as well. You don't exactly sound thrilled. Fortunately, she also likes space travel operas. I see. Learning couple compromises the hard way. I suppose so. Well, I'm glad to hear that she's met Amanda and that they get along. Does that mean she also knows where you're from, Silver? She does. In fact, I told her about that on our first date. Wow! That's very brave! It's very hard to put yourself out there under any circumstances to reveal something so vulnerable to someone you just met and are starting to like. It takes guts. You're very kind, but I don't think so. To be honest, I hadn't planned it that way. Although I have always felt safe here with all the regulars, I know that not everyone would be open-minded about me. And so I wasn't sure I'd say anything to Pearl that night. But as we were talking, I was so happy to learn more about her, about who she is, and I realized I didn't want her to have an incomplete picture of me. My past is a part of me. If my goal is to find someone who sees me for who I am, then she needs to know about that too. Aww. Mike, how did an alien get it right the first time and like most guys in the world can't? They all need to take a lesson from Silver. And in the end, that was the right decision.
Well, I will say that if she heard your story, and that changed how she viewed you, then she wouldn't have been worth your time anyway. That's fair. But still, even knowing that, I admire you a lot. The truth is, and this is a bit of a strange thing to say, but I think I'm proud of who I've become. And I want the people I love to be proud of me too. Oh, Silver, you're gonna make me fucking cry.
What is proud?
Proud is... For yourself, I think it's when you start to be satisfied with what you're achieving, especially if you have to fight to get there. And for others, it's when you think of someone you care about, consider who they are and the way they're acting, and it just fills you with joy.
Ah, we see. Then we are definitely proud of you.
Oh, I fucking love these guys! Oh... I... You two are a really sweet family.
And so are you and Miss Lua, Mr. Baileys.
True, chosen families can also rock.
Yes, when we met Pearl, we came to a conclusion. There is no difference in nature or expression between a family that you are born with and a family that you acquire by choice. Both demand work and understanding. There might be minute differences in the specific process, but the bond appears to be 99.999% similar in the end. So it is.
Oh, look at all. I'm gonna cry.
Well, we should probably get going.
Yes, we must go pack.
First time I see someone get excited about that specific part.
What Amanda really meant, what really means is that I must pack.
While she analyzes the earthling ritual of folding shirts, rolling up socks, and so on.
Precisely. This is further information for our research. We are thrilled.
Good luck, Silver.
Indeed.
Do enjoy your trip, both of you. I hope you'll tell us about it when you're back, Silver.
I will.
Good night to you too, then.
Hasta la vista, strangers.
Huh?
Orc Westerns.
Ah, bye to you too.
Oh.
I fucking love those two. Oh my god. It's never a dull moment in your cafe, cat.
I try. Speaking of which, would you like to hold some party or after party for your wedding here? I know it's not a very large space, but perhaps...
Whether we'd like it?
We love it! Honestly, I don't want to impose, but there's no place that could be a better fit. And I don't mind that it's not very large. It's going to be a small, cozy wedding. So this is perfect.
It's settled then!
Ah, Lua's gonna be over the moon when I tell her. In fact, I'm going to go and tell her now. That's a very exciting prospect.
It really is!
Thanks again, Kat. You're like a guardian angel for us. And on that note, I'm off. Good night.
Oh, I love them. They finally came to terms for a nice, small, cozy wedding with just like their most important people. And we get to be a part of it. Oh,
amazing. More like guardian hive mind.
Good night, Mr. Baileys.
So sweet. I swear if Amanda said, I'll be back. I think that's why they went with Hasta la Vista.
September 30th.
So, are they... Wait.
Are they getting married? I'm trying to think. They said in a couple of days. I wonder if they'd be getting married the same time that John and I got married in October.
That'd be pretty cool. And also ironic. ZXX20 virus vaccine booster ready for distribution. Nekomimi driver crashes truck filled with catnip, suspected DUI. UFO previously spotted by Space Guard fighters, a very determined hot air balloon. Interesting.
Wait.
I gotta see. So, see if there's anything else here. Aww. She gave me a hug. Aww. Taking an easy care day because self-care is important. Okay. Good night. Okay. So, what we got? Got that. That's a new one from last time. Hello, Miss Aqua.
Hi, Cat. How are you?
Good, as usual. How about you?
Honestly, lots of things have happened. Can I order something first, though?
Of course. What would you like?
Can you make me a cup of chai?
Chai? What is chai? Isn't that just tea milk? Oh, God. I don't know. Is it like tea milk milk? Is that what that is? I think it's tea. Is it matcha? Is it tea milk milk? There's quite a bit of milk in it. That's a tea latte. What's chai? Is it... I drink chai and I don't even know what's in it. Isn't that sad? Oh no. Is it, isn't chai spicy? Not always. It, like, depending... Like, I've had chai tea that does have a little bit of spice, and then I've had chai tea that is, like, bland, but also, like, nice. Tea, milk, ginger? Let me see. No, that's the Galahad. So that's not that. Tea milk cinnamon is the Shia Denny. Tea milk milk, isn't it? Is it matcha? That's green tea latte. Tea ginger milk? I could try, let me try one more time. I'll try tea, ginger, milk. And if I don't get it, then I'll... No, that's just ginger milk tea. Okay. What's the recipe for chai? No, I don't think it has honey in it at all. It's either cinnamon or ginger. Maybe it's tea cinnamon milk? Tea milk cinnamon? Ginger sounds too strong for tea. Yeah, maybe it's tea milk cinnamon. Or tea cinnamon milk. cinnamon milk.
Tea ginger cinnamon, really?
Tea ginger cinnamon.
There's no milk in it?
That is so weird. That's a masala chai. I mean, I guess that's chai.
I guess so.
So it's ginger and cinnamon. A cup of masala chai for the lady with eclectic tastes.
Thank you. It's delicious.
You're welcome. So, you were saying?
Oh, right. It's just I've been busy working on my game.
I see. How's it going?
It's pretty difficult, but I'll manage.
I'm glad to hear that. How's that contract you talked about the other day going?
Chai doesn't have milk in it at all? Are you serious?
That is bizarre.
Oh, that. I rejected it, of course. There's no saving it, really, which is a shame. I truly like their games. But with all the shady requirements they had, I could tell they looked down at us small developers. And the scary thing is, if I hadn't known what I know now, just because they're a publisher I loved a lot, I would have overlooked all that.
That's understandable, though. You trusted them not to take advantage of you.
Well, it has to be fair for both of us, right? Because at the end of the day, it's business, but I don't know.
Yeah.
Actually, I tried negotiating with them because I wondered if they still had any good faith left. Don't tell Myrtle, okay?
Okay.
But as I expected, it really didn't go anywhere. Instead, they insisted they're doing me a favor since I'm just a small developer. And I wasn't thinking rationally or in business terms.
Oof. Doesn't sound like good faith to me.
Right? Considering the unfair conditions they're expecting me to accept, they could have at least been polite about it.
I doubt they care, though.
Yeah.
What's up?
Nothing.
Is it about Myrtle?
Oh? Well, sort of. We haven't talked much since our little argument. Only checking in here and there. I'm going to a tech mall so I can look for parts to upgrade my PC.
Oh?
Yeah, I hope to get a good deal there. I wish Myrtle would apologize, though, for treating me as if I'm totally clueless. If she did, I could ask her to help me pick the right parts now, you know? But I know I was in the wrong, too. I wasn't being clear with my words, with my anxiety talking and all. But I already told her I'd reject the contract, right?
Yes, I heard you say that.
She should have tried to listen a bit.
Sorry to hear you're having a hard time.
It's fine. It was just bad timing.
Clearly you care about each other, though. So you two will make up eventually, I'm sure of it.
Yeah. Thanks, Kat. That cheers me up a little.
Anytime.
I suppose I better go now, so I can shop around as long as I want. Maybe I'll go get something nice for myself, too.
Like what?
Maybe a new bolster? My current one is no longer firm.
Ah, I see. Well, I hope you have a good time.
Me too. Thank you, Kat. I'll see you later.
Take care.
Oh, like the slithery, like, squishy noise. Let's see.
I guess I'll go over today's checklist. Okay, hold on a second. Da, 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 da. So, we got that. Close. Oops, oops, oops. This one. Do, 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 do. Nice, nice. And then nothing new. Cool. Now what?
What the heck? On Google, every recipe I've seen mentions milk. That's what I thought. Oh my god! Nekomimi Daddy!
here! Well, hello, gentlemen!
Hey, Cat.
Cat!
I get to be an old man now! Nice seeing you here, Hendry. How goes it?
Good, good, good. I see you're doing good, too.
As usual. What do you want to drink, Hendry? It's on me.
No, no, no. That won't do.
Well, let's talk about bills later. So, what will it be? You first.
You sure? Okie dokie. I'll have one STMJ, please.
Okay, I forget what that is. Let's see if it's in my thing. Da-da-da-da-da. It's here. Milk, ginger, honey. Milk, ginger, honey, brew. There it is! And I shall serve it? Wait, is there... Okay, no, that's for... That's for the officer. This is for... Should I give the invite to... Should I give the invite to Gala? Or should I wait and give the invite to... Cat Grandpa, yeah. I don't know. One STMJ coming up.
Ah, it smells so nice. Spot on. Thanks, Cat.
You're very welcome. How about you, sir?
Oh, it's my turn. Something with ginger, please.
Anything else with that?
Well, what would you recommend?
Anything from your new tea line is fine.
Oh, I see you have a new selection.
Yes, we have blue pea and hibiscus tea available.
Hibiscus, huh? You should try...
Tajay Rosella. It's pretty good for this kind of weather.
Sounds familiar. It's ginger steeped with Roselle buds, another name for hibiscus.
Anything else in it?
Well, it's a bit sweet.
Interesting. I'll try it then. A Tajay Rosella. Okay, again, forgot how to make it. So... Hibiscus, ginger, honey. Hibiscus, ginger, honey. Should I give him the invite? In a few days, I don't know when I will see Hyde. I'm just gonna give him that. Let's serve it and see what happens. What's this? Oh, it's Bailey's and Lua's wedding invitation.
Really?
For Hyde. Oh. The date is really soon. Could you pass it along to him since I'm not sure when he'll be here? Okay, sure. Thank you. A piping hot cup of Tajay Rosella for you.
Thanks.
What do you think, Hendry? Does it look any good? Uh-oh.
It looks about right. It smells good too, try it.
Yup, it's good. Glad I passed your impromptu test.
So, what's been going on?
Did I miss anything?
Something happened, didn't it?
You can say that. I think the officer is coming too, by the way. Alright.
As for me, I'm just glad my fury is over. Are you okay, though? I'm fine, as you can see. How are you managing, Hendry? Did you get your checkup?
I did. Rachel pestered me to get it done all week, so I had to do it.
Good.
There's no doubt I need to slow down. I can feel it in my bones. Time is a harsh mistress, as they say. Ain't that the truth? But I don't think you get to complain, though.
Why not? You know my body isn't what it used to be anymore.
Oh?
I mean, compared to my prime. 50 years ago. I'm kidding. Truth is, my body doesn't hold up well when transforming anymore.
Oh, is that so?
Yep.
The soreness doesn't go away as quick as it used to. It's harder to get up in the morning after all that, like today. I know that feeling all too well. Especially in this kind of weather.
Oh?
It's like my body knows if a storm's gonna get worse. No weather forecast can match the accuracy of my joints.
And you know what? I never understood that growing up, but now in my mid-30s, I get it. Like, my knees will hurt, my back will hurt. I can't describe it other than when the weather changes, my joints stiffen. It's so freaking weird, especially when it's cold and rainy. I just know what it's gonna be like before I even look at the weather. And it is the most bizarre thing to experience when you have no idea what it's like until you have it. But it's not a superpower I want, but it's a superpower apparently a lot of us get as we get older. It's crazy. Well, lucky for you, ginger is great for sore muscles.
Is it?
For real? Do I need to eat more ginger in my life?
Yeah.
Oh, there's Officer Georgie.
Hey, folks. The man of the hour.
Hiya, Georgie.
Get what I miss?
Some very important weather talk.
Is that so? Sounds like I missed a ton, then.
How are you?
How am I? If you're talking about my case, well, I don't even know where to begin.
Hendry, you know nothing about what I'm about to say, right?
No, what are we talking about?
Cat, you should have primed him before I got here.
My bad.
In my defense, I didn't know you were coming until Mr. Gala mentioned it.
Excuses.
I'll help explain it to Hendry. In short, there's been a string of car vandalisms nearby.
And then catch it. Oh boy.
So he's trying to figure out if the tree being gone has anything to do with the case.
That's where we are now.
Look at his shoulder was all like pew, pew, pew. I freaking love it.
Yep, that's about it.
That's a lot to take in. Anything new happened since?
Well, I tried something. I set a few candles where the tree was. I used my lighter and things happened.
Oh.
Mind backing up a bit?
Feels like there's a lot of context missing here.
Well, I'm warning ya. Everything I'm about to tell you is real. It'll sound a little crazy, but no, I haven't lost it yet. Got it?
Loud and clear.
I told Kat about my lighter a while ago. How it might be connected to the fairy market we talked about before.
Really? In what way?
The lighter was my grandpop's, and there's a chance he bought it from there.
Ah, interesting.
Yeah, what a coincidence, eh? Anyways, my daughter likes this sort of mystery stuff, right? After talking to her about what's been going on, she believed my lighter was the key to making sense of all this, and gave me some pointers. So, I went back there last night, to the spot, you know? To where the tree used to be. I lit a few candles there, put the lighter right in the middle of it all. I'll be honest, It was spooky as heck. The air was still, and I felt tension in my head. Wasn't sure if it was just me being creeped out or if there was something else going on. What is that? You know, Fatal. And then what happened? Right, okay. I love how they argued about that. They're like, what is that noise? Oh, did we crash? You missed a lot. Well, Cooper's getting some head scratches right now. Buffer. Oh no. I didn't realize that the stream was down. I'm sorry. Well, I don't know where the stream crashed, but basically they've just been talking about what Georgie just did. He went back to the tree place and lit some candles, and he said his lighter exploded. So that's where we're at, basically. So they're just going back and forth about what he means that the lighter exploded. Sorry, I didn't know the stream crashed. Nothing went down on my end. That's weird. Yeah, basically he said spooky stuff happened, and now he's just saying his lighter exploded when he lit a bunch of candles at the thing. No drop frame rates here. It says 60 FPS. Drop frame rates 0%. So, it must be a Twitch thing. Not sure. I'm sorry. I didn't know. I'm sorry. But anyway. Then I immediately looked back to see it had fallen over with its lid open. The flame, it was burning white. Wow. Ain't gonna lie to y'all. I freaked the frick out. But before I could do anything, two small figures emerged from the corner, walking toward the lighter. Oh. Did they see you? Yeah, they did. They inspected my lighter while I was just standing there. Then they asked me straight up, Is this lighter yours, guy? I said, yeah. Then I fired a question back. Are you the ones who've been messing with cars around here lately? And they said yes. Well, sounds like case closed. So they weren't ghosts? Hell no, thank God for that. Then who are they? Let's just say they were close friends of the deceased. They're part of the fairy folk, but I didn't expect them at all. Didn't expect? Do you know them? Kinda. In fact, they own the gnome noms near my place. Oh wow. Did they know it was your car then? Nope, because I only order takeout. And I usually walk there. What was the reason for all the vandalism then? It all started because of a broken promise. And we have to start way back for that. You remember why the tree there was in the, why the tree was there in the first place, right? Yeah. The tragic hit and run. At the time, the court ruling practically let the driver off the hook outside the DUI charge. Well, it sparked a huge protest. Good! In response to it, the mayor at the time gave his word to the victim's family. He promised to keep the tree as a landmark for the community, and the vow was kept well after his tenure was over. But he died a few years ago, and we all know recently what happened to the tree. I see. So it was their attempt to keep the memory alive, not just for their friend, but as a remembrance of the injustice as well. And after all the urban renewals the city's gone through, makes sense if the community that used to be there is gone by now. That's right. There used to be a lot of veteran housing and low-rise apartments in the area. Now it's filled with never-ending projects. You okay?
Oh, yeah. Sorry. There's something about it that bothers me a bit.
Like what?
Their unique disposition after they pass. It bothers me that their own memories are insufficient to ensure their existence, and by failing to remember, we, the outside party, will also gradually lose track of their existence. It just doesn't feel right to me.
I get what you mean. An odd eraser of existence.
But apparently that's why they keep animals. The Gnome Nom's owners told me they have a large mastiff living in their place.
Oh, a large dog, large pupper.
Others even take care of multiple animals at once.
Interesting. I suppose that's why some folk prefer living near the wilderness.
But animals don't live long either.
Right.
But the erasure starts happening if they're completely forgotten, right?
Something like that, I guess. I'm not sure.
Right, okay. But doesn't that normally happen anyway? How do we pay respects or remember someone who died a long time ago? Like our ancestors, for example. It's our call, isn't it?
Every April, Rachel and I would visit my wife's grave. We used to visit her grandparents' graves, too, when my wife was still alive. If our extended family was visiting, they'd join us. We clean their gravestones, bring food, and have a feast while catching up. It's how Nekomimis honor the dead, and I'm sure other cultures have their own ways too.
See this? This, I'm gonna go off topic for a smidge here, but not off topic, but on topic, off, you know what I mean. I find a lot of cemeteries, I find them peaceful. But I also find them sad because it just, a lot of times in America, cemeteries just feel like wasted space for the most part. It feels like a place where loved ones bury their loved ones and then that's it. There are quite a bit of people who will go and, like Hendry mentioned, they will go and clean up their gravestones and, you know, visit and pay respects. But there are a lot of people who don't, or there are a lot of people who can't. And I feel like for people like that, I feel like the purpose of a gravestone is forgotten. I feel like people just kind of bury people because it's cheaper and they don't know what to do and it's just common. So when you die, you just get buried. That's it. But I feel like if you're not going to have the responsibility of, you know, tending to the grave, visiting your loved ones, this and that, then there's no point to it. Like, there's no shame in not having one, but there's also no point in having one. It would just be easier to just not be buried, you know what I mean? But it's like how people also view death if they need a place for that, you know? It's weird. But a lot of other cultures, when their loved ones die, like in Japan and stuff, there's like a whole like thing that they do to respect the ones who've passed. It's very different in other cultures. So I like how they mention, like, this is how the Nekomimis honor the dead. Like, this is what we do. This is our thing. And a lot of other cultures have really, like, interesting ways of honoring their dead. Like, what? Day of the Dead, Mexico. Like, there's a whole thing. But, like, us, it's just, like, it's not really customary. It's just, do you want to be cremated or put in the ground? And that's pretty much it. Like, there's nothing fancy about it. It's just, what do you want? And then there's no cultural thing. It's just whatever your family wishes or whatever is left for you or whatever your relative had paid for before they died or left in their will or something. It's just, it's odd. You know what I mean? I wish there was more to it, but there isn't.
Right.
I truly think continuing the tradition is something we do for ourselves, though. To remember the deceased and all the reasons they mattered to us. So, except for the weird erased memory part, it sounds on par to me. It's the effort of the living to remember the dead anyway.
Precisely.
You're right. Unless you believe in life after death, memories are for us, not for the dead.
Exactly.
Pretty much.
Because when you die, it doesn't really matter to you. Like, when I'm dead, it doesn't matter what happens to me because I'm dead. You know? I'm not gonna think about myself after I'm dead. I'm just dead. But it's up to the people that you have met, that you have, you know, that are, you are related to, that care about you, your friends, your family, your loved ones. It's up to them to remember you after you're gone. And that's like the peaceful afterlife connection, I guess, is not really to leave a mark or an impression, like something significant, but just to have a memory. Just for someone to be like, hey, I remembered Kat. I remembered, you know, meeting her or being friends with her or doing some, you know, that is what it should be after you pass. It shouldn't be, you know, oh, I remember them because they were rich, or I remember them because they were famous, or I remember them because they were a fucking astronaut or something. You know, it's about your impression, but it doesn't have to be fancy. It just, you leave a footprint, so to speak. It would be great if we could all remember and help each other. Because keeping track of any sort of history is a team effort. Since the best way to gain wisdom is to learn from the past, whether it's bad or good. Yeah. Speaking of the Gnome Nom's owners, though, what happened to them after all that? Oh, right, did you arrest them? Nope. Huh? Are you going to let them go? Not necessarily. But I got an idea on what I have to do. Right now, I'm just happy there's no ghosts involved. Still, it was truly something else. Yeah, what a night it must have been. It is what it is. Are you gonna order something, Georgie? What's up, big guy? Something on your mind? No, nothing. A shame about that lighter of yours, though. Oh yeah, it's probably busted, right? That's the thing. It works just fine, not even a scratch. Really? But that thing blew up, didn't it? Like, patah! Heck, we even debated the sound effects and everything! As I said, it still works fine. So I don't know what else to tell you. I see. You want to know what I think? No. You want to know what I think? No. It's haunted. No, it's not. That thing is definitely haunted. What are you talking about? The white flame is a bit unnatural, I agree. And I remember how you kept forgetting your lighter here? Hey now. A man is allowed to forget stuff as he gets older, no? As for the blowing up, it was probably a well-timed bad chemical reaction or something. This thing is real old after all. If that's the case, you might want to stop carrying it around. At any rate, I believe you now, officer. There's no such thing as coincidence, indeed. Oh, eat your own words, Georgie! I'm mixing up frickin' voices. I still think it's a ghost, though. Shut it, Hendry. Shush. In any case, mystery solved. For now, at least. Oh, is that his daughter? Hmm? Oh no, I think I have to go now. I didn't realize I missed multiple messages earlier because I was so engrossed in your story. Sorry to rush off. I'll see you all again next time. Sure, safe trip. Nice seeing you again, Hendry. Take care. Whoosh. Let me move over there. Whoosh. You know, all that talk made me thirsty. You want anything? I'm good. Then one espresso for me, please. Okay. Espresso, espresso, espresso. It's coffee, coffee, coffee. Coffee, coffee, coffee. And then we're going to put that there. There we go. Serve it. What is it? It's Miss Riona's number.
She asked me to give it to you. She said she can help you find someone if you need it, or if you need any information from her.
I see. Well, I'm sure it'll come in handy. Thank you.
Here's your espresso, officer.
Thanks.
A tall drink of Gala. Everybody loves Gala. Everyone in chat has the hots for Gala. Man or woman, they have the hots for Gala.
Great as always.
So what's next, officer? What's your plan after this?
Other than talking to him? I guess I'll focus on the rumors. Word is going around that cars are being messed up there.
That's kind of expected, though, isn't it?
There's no point in adding to citizens' worries when the case is pretty much over. And I don't want bad press to paint over the area's history.
You're right. There's nothing like rumors. Without being stopped, they'll just spiral out of control.
I have a question for you, though. Which do you prefer, wild rumors or bad press?
That's a tough one. There's no limit to what wild rumors can become or how far they'll go. But the press can shape a story, report it, and many will believe it as truth. Both are worrying in their own ways.
Fair point. But what if we combine them?
Rumor, truth, and press.
If we somehow combine them, then I think I have a plan. A crazy one, but a plan nonetheless. Maybe y'all can also add to it.
Oh? Sure.
It'll take a while to explain, though.
Well, I'll be here all night.
I got time.
All right, then.
Brace yourselves, folks. It's gonna be a doozy.
Okay, because I don't want to listen to it.